I was working for Nestle in Moga, and I was coming to Maharashtra, Nagpur. I was driving the Fiat car. I was supposed to drive up to Delhi. After my car crossed Ludhiana, Ambala, on the national highway, it took a somersault. It rolled like that. I used to drive at a very high speed. It rolled and it came back to normal. Car was, nothing happened to the car. And there were three junior engineers of mine. Nothing happened to them. And to their horror, they saw that I am bleeding profusely. My whole back, shirt back was filled with blood. And they said, "Why? Nothing happened to you, sir?" I said, "No, don't say like that." Quickly they moved me to a nearby hospital. The doctor looked at me and said, "Are you a living being or a ghost? You should have been dead by now. There's a deep injury, deep cut on your head." Some 12, 13 stitches he put, and he gave some local anesthesia, some painkillers, some antibiotics, and he said, "You must immediately get admitted to either All India Institute or CMC Ludhiana or PGI Chandigarh. You cannot be like this." I said, "Nothing is happening to me. Not even a pinprick. And I can speak, I can see, I can think. Nothing." Then he said, "It is up to you." Anyway, those days I used to chant only one mantra. Krishnaya Vasudevaya Hare Paramatmane Pranataklesanashaya Govindaya Namo Namaha. With that mantra in my mind, I reached Delhi, and then I took flight and reached home. And when I reached my sister's house in Maharashtra, she smiled at me and she said, "I want to tell you something." Then I said, "Why don't you look at me, what has happened?" She said, "Regarding that, what you carry on your head, a bandage, I want to tell you something." I said, "What happened?" "There, just the time when I had this accident, a painless 15 stitches injury," she said, "that is the time when I was sleeping and she got a dream. And in that dream she saw that a huge mountain had fallen on me and I am buried in that." Then Bhagwan Baba appears in the vision. She had not seen Baba physically. Madhari Baba used to say, "You will all go there as per his will whenever he calls, but one day certainly all of you will see him." Anyway, she saw Baba, and then Baba picked me out of the mountain and he lifted me and he kicked on my back and he said, "Come on, walk. I am giving you second life in the same body. It was death, I have removed it. And you will come to me, you will stay with me, you will serve me." These were 4 or 5 sentences which Swami told my sister. Anyway, I had to believe this because the doctor said the injury is so huge, so much of loss of blood. And then time went like that. Later on I came to Baba. This happened in March 1986. And in 1989, after 3 years, Swami was talking to our class and Swami looked at me and he said, "Kya sister ke dream mein aaya? Hum sister ke dream mein second life diya. Bahut tej car chalata hai Punjab mein pehle. Bad boy, rowdy driver. Second life दिया तुमको. आज के बाद कोई टू व्हीलर, कोई फोर व्हीलर, कुछ नहीं ड्राइव करना." So Swami, just see this. 3 years after the incidents, so many things happened in between, but he revealed. This was in 89. In 92 or 93, after a long gap, I was sitting at the feet of Mallari Baba and he looked at me and he said, some 300, 400 people were sitting in his ashram in the Sanctum Sanctorum, the Puja Hall, where he sits and delivers lectures. And he told me, come on, today you give talk. Tell about your experiences in company of Satya Sai Baba. Then I said, I will tell, certainly. Then I narrated this experience, that how Baba saved my life, how he extended my life, and how he fulfilled the promise given to my sister in her dream. Everything I narrated. Then he said, stop, wait. Then I said, what does it mean? This is where. What does it mean? I said, I was dumbfounded. I had no answer. What does it mean? Means what? I kept quiet. Baba, I don't know. Then he said, look, Baba gives you all experiences. He gives experiences, he doesn't give you explanations. I am giving you explanation to prove his might, what he is. Then I said, please. Then he told. Then he said, where were you? You were in Punjab. Where was your sister? She was in Maharashtra. Where was Baba? Bhagwan Baba was in that time in Bangalore, Andhra, Karnataka, South. And you were not in his physical contact. You did not even make prayers to him to save. Nothing. You were only saying Krishna Aya Vasudevaya all the time. I said, yes. So, Bhagavan coming to your sister's dream and saving life, that is true. Because he has confirmed and it is true, you are gone. He saved your life in somebody else's dream, somewhere, not in his proximity. Then he said, the one, this is very important explanation, the one who transcends time and space, Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupta, the three avastas, the one who can alter the journey of your life, who can make death come in the dream. Only Supreme Purna Avatar, Purna Purusha only can do this. Only Purna Purusha, Purna Avatar can do this. Then he said, Baba did not change any law or any rule. He said, take this very carefully. What Satya Sai Baba can do, take this very carefully. And he said, cash on this power of Baba. Take shelter under in this mighty power of Satya Sai Baba and march ahead spiritually.